six, ordinance number 2012-221, to declare a public necessity void to authorize the acquisition of real property known as 1801 Commerce Road for the purpose of housing the Department of Public Utilities, water and wastewater plant, laboratory operations, stormwater operations, and wastewater collection field operations.
Mr. Clark, does any of the other papers relate to this address as well?
Yes, item number seven is related, and that's ordinance number 2012-222, to amend ordinance number 2012-34-70, adopted May 14, 2012, to amend fiscal year 2012-13 capital budget by transferring funds in to the amount of $2,551,300 from the wastewater treatment plant project in the utilities category and appropriate $460,850 of the transfer of funds to the sanitary sewer project in the utilities category. $1,419,700 of the transfer of funds to the major plant and pumping improvement projects in the utilities category, and $670,750 to the stormwater facility improvement project in the utilities category for the purpose of providing funds for the acquisition of 1801 Commerce Road to enable the relocation of the Department of Public Utilities, water and wastewater plant laboratory operations, stormwater operations, and wastewater collection field operations.
Okay, are there questions on these papers? How many? You have questions, Mr. Jewell, Ms. Trammell, anyone else? Why don't we have a brief presentation and I think we'll take the questions from there.
Thank you, Madam Vice President. Bob Stiedel, Utilities Director. I'm going to put a little bit of context, and then Mr. Horton is going to give a presentation on the facilities and centers. As you all know, or as you may know, the water and wastewater facilities were built in the 1950s. They were last improved in the 1980s. And this whole process started with the state of Virginia passed new regulations that required updates to the drinking water and environmental laboratories in January of 2009. So we began by looking at this process as a way of starting there. We also had in 1995, the Utilities Department had absorbed the Wastewater Collections Division from the Department of Public Works. And we were running out of space in the wastewater administration building, so in the CIP that we presented to you back in 2009 included the improvements to the wastewater plant administration building, which would take care of the laboratory improvements as well as give us some additional space that we could have the wastewater collections group have more room for their work. We first of all started out by trying to move into the biotech park, but we found out we couldn't negotiate a lease that was acceptable to all of the biotech parks. So at that time, we took the planning study that we had then, and then we looked at trying to locate a facility at the wastewater plant. As you know, the wastewater plant does flood, so there's only certain parts of the plant we could actually build this facility out of the floodplain. And we had a good plan to go forward. We at that time put into the budget a project that was $10.9 million to do this work, and we were going down that path until later in 2009, both the flood wall and the stormwater group was again transferred to the utilities department from Public Works. And at that time, we really had an overcrowding and equipment storage and maintenance problem at both the Morgan Street facility for the wastewater plant as well as the operations center on Jeff Davis Highway. That led Mr. Horton and Ms. Burtz to take another look at this process, go back out and rethink what we were trying to do. And in the summer of 2011, they started a reevaluation process that included the laboratories, the wastewater and the stormwater collections group, and the industrial source control. And what they found was a much superior plan than what we had originally done in our planning process by looking at this location at 1801 Commerce. And Mr. Horton will explain that to you now.
Good afternoon, Madam Vice President, members of Council. My name is Will Gordon, Deputy Director for Public Utilities. As Mr. Stiedel has here is the issue of space availability, which... is, okay. I'm having only about job training here. Okay. And so what we've looked at is an opportunity here to maximize the human resources that we have, first starting with the laboratory. We've looked at ways to increase the capacity of jobs that tasks that need to be performed by the laboratory. And we've got two separate labs right now, one at the water plant and one at the wastewater plant. Both labs are certified either by the Department of Public Health or by the Department of Environmental Quality. By consolidating these labs, we will be able to do cross-training and possibly reduce the need for external laboratory contracts, which we now have to do in order to meet all the regulatory requirements. We have consolidated the efforts between stormwater and wastewater in 2011. This is the field operations portion, maintenance area. The issue here is the ability to have them both co-located, and also the issue exists with storage of equipment, and I will get more into that as we move forward. Where we talk about the housing for weather-sensitive equipment. We also looked at brownfield properties on Commerce. This particular property that we're looking at is a brownfield that's being mitigated at this point. And we looked at the hazards. The hazards have been reduced, and we believe within a short period of time will be remedied and will be eliminated. And finally, we looked at ways to highlight the innovative stormwater management processes that we're trying to promote in the community, and this facility will give us an opportunity to do that. From a consolidation perspective, currently, as I've indicated, we've got two laboratories, one at the water plant, one at the wastewater plant. Both facilities are in desperate need of additional space to accommodate the additional equipment needed to do all of the multiple tests that are required, both from a potable water, drinking water perspective, and also to meet discharge from our wastewater facilities. In addition, they also are responsible for testing from environmental compliance with some of our industrial and commercial customers. This provides an efficient facility to facilitate the sampling process. It ensures long-term certification for both water and wastewater. It provides the cross-training opportunities that we're looking for as we move forward. And it removes the stumbling blocks that we have because of the limited space that exists at both facilities. In addition, I've mentioned the consolidation of the fill operations for stormwater and wastewater by acquiring 1801. We will have the ability to co-locate both of these operations under one umbrella, giving us the opportunity to better facilitate the effective use of the human resources and the equipment that is common in both areas. It provides us the storage facilities for some of our more sensitive weather equipment that we have, and I'll get to that in more detail in my next slide. It also helps us to reduce the maintenance costs by protecting this equipment, and I'll cover that. Well, actually, I can do it now. On the sensitive equipment, we have approximately 7 pieces of equipment that are rather large, and they cost us somewhere in the neighborhood of $375,000 to $400,000 a piece. During cold weather, these vehicles have vessels on them. We call them vacuums. They have vessels on them that goes out and cleans out in drop inlets, storm drain lines and sanitary sewer lines. Because they store water during cold weather, certain lines and whatnot can freeze up and cause damage to the equipment. We have experienced somewhere in the neighborhood of $250,000 to $400,000 a year in trying to maintain these pieces of equipment, because not having adequate storage facilities has created some problems. By having this facility, it not only accommodates these pieces of equipment that I've mentioned, but several other pieces of equipment that can also be damaged during cold weather. We believe that we would save on an annual basis somewhere in the neighborhood of $300,000 a year just on maintenance costs by having a proper place to store the equipment and provide operator maintenance type services to these pieces of equipment. Presently, these pieces of equipment are stored outside either at our Jeff Davis Operations Center location or at the wastewater facility behind the warehouse. This slide kind of gives an outlay of the location of the facility. The facility is basically in the southwest sector of East Commerce Grove. It sits on 5 acres. The building is approximately 51,000 square feet. This facility will allow us to accommodate 90 city employees that will include the stormwater collections, wastewater collections, the laboratory, environmental compliance, and I think that's it, for a total of 90 personnel. The price that is shown here that we're going to be able to purchase this building for is $750,000. The original asking price was $1.2 million. The closing cost is $38,500, bringing the total cost to $788,500. With the renovation costs to renovate, build the laboratory could be the bigger portion of this, about $1.4 million, as opposed to about $3,182,000. Madam Vice Chair, this completes my portion of the presentation.
Thank you, sir. Ms.
Trammell,
there's a question. Sir, you
Yes, I've not seen it, but the new digs for Public Works off of Commerce Road, I'm told is equivalent to three blocks of property. There's no chance that Public Works and Utilities could co-locate at this site with that much square footage. Again, I haven't seen it, so I could be way out in the high weeds.
The square footage for utility is necessary for the work that Mr. Horton told you. We've taken that out of the Public Works Department, so I assume that they were not planning on having us move back in again. I mean, when we took all that away, we actually freed them up their space. I don't know about their specific property.
Well, Mr. Beschler,
we have a space planner that's taking a look at the remaining properties on what we're calling phase two on Parker Field. As you recall, on the North Boulevard site, that we're doing that in two sections. What we call phase one is where the fleet and the school's warehouse is. And that property is going to, the Crenshaw property on Commerce Grove is where we're going to locate the fleet. And to your point, there are additional buildings on what we're calling a Crenshaw property on Commerce Road. What we're doing is we have a space planner that's taking a look at the remaining DPW facilities that still are there on Parker Field, and we're trying to locate those on the Crenshaw property. So
Public Works could consume all of this space.
Exactly, that's exactly right.
And then some.
Just that planning study will tell us that, yes.
What's the road, Viva, I'm trying to think of, where the public works dump and all that stuff is now? No.
Hopkins Road?
Hopkins, yeah. Any of that gonna relocate to the new site?
Not at the present time, possibly in the future, but we do no plans right now to do that.
All right, just checking, and the property where the laboratory will be vacated, what will become of it?
At the water plant, the battery would go into the maintenance shop, that would then go for the maintenance electricians trades that work there. And at the wastewater plant, that location would go into, either the trades can work out of there, or we also have, we'll also need some space for the operations group, you know, we're just upgrading that plant now for nitrogen phosphorus removal, and that additional space could be used for a centralized control room and other space that we need in wastewater plants.
So you got a plan, use?
I'm not gonna run out of uses for square footage for the area.
Thank you.
Okay, are there any other questions? I'm sorry, Dr. Noodle, do you have a question?
Yes, I'm looking at a question on the last page of my presentation of this program. I'm looking at a question on the last page of this presentation, targeting the reactors for the water testing. Okay, I have a pick. How do we explain the 2008 study identified 3.05 in upgrades, but we have a different amount in CIP?
For the wastewater facility?
Yes.
Are you looking at next steps in time?
No.
No, I think one of your maybe worksheets on the presentation that we received, it has two questions on it. One is, do we want to add the slide or just discuss? And the second one is how we would explain the 2008 study. Excuse me, identify $3.5 million of WWTP upgrades. A CIP project is 10.9.
Oh, okay. As Mr. Stiedel indicated, the original price tag on renovating the wastewater facility was 10.5 to $11 million. The larger laboratory is located at the wastewater facility. In this renovation, if we move forward with this renovation, we would have located the water laboratory to the wastewater facility to accommodate this. Because of the price that we've been able to negotiate on the 1801 facility, it moves this very critical operation out of the floodplain into, on the protected side of the flood wall, at a cost of only $700,000. The renovation for that portion of the building where the laboratory will be is about $1.4 million. So we actually save almost $8 million with this move. Does that make sense, Pat?
It absolutely does. I was hopeful that that was the answer, the
yes,
save part especially.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Item number 8, ordinance number 2012-224.